Once upon a time, a beautiful princess was born.
Why don't we celebrate Josh's birth with the whole kingdom? That's a great idea. Let's have a big party.
The happy king and queen gave a feast. They invited all of the good fairies in the land.
Hello, fairies. You're all very welcome.
Thank you for coming.
One by one, each fairy gave the baby princess a gift. One gave her beauty. One gave her grace. And on and on. Finally, the last good fairy approached the cradle.
For her final gift, I give the princess the gift of...
Hello everyone! What a lovely party, I would have loved to attend. But it seems my invitation got lost in the mail.
We're so sorry, we didn't know you still lived in the
it's
area.
It's too late for apologies. Now, I have a gift to give the little princess as well. On her 16th birthday, she'll prick her finger on the spindle of the spinning wheel and die!
No, please not my baby!
Please, we're so sorry.
It's too late! Read the words of your witness!
Can you break this spell, good fairy? Please save my daughter.
The good fairy carefully examined the curse.
I cannot break the spell, but I can make it better. When she pricks her finger on her 16th birthday, she will not die. She will only sleep for 100 years.
100 years? No! I have a great idea. If there are no spindles, she cannot prick her finger. Burn all the spindles in the land.
My good king, that's
be gone from here. We'll keep our daughter safe since you cannot.
On her 16th birthday, the princess climbed up a tower she had never visited before.
Never seen this tower before. Wonder what's inside.
Inside, an old lady was spinning on a spinning wheel that had, by magic, been overlooked.
Hello, what are you doing?
I'm spinning.
Oh, please, let me try.
Of course, young lady, come closer.
When she reached for the spindle,
ow, I pricked my finger!
The princess fell into a deep sleep and the wicked fairy disappeared right back. The good fairy, who had secretly watched over the kingdom for 16 years, appeared to offer what protection she could.
I will send the whole palace and her parents to sleep, so when she wakes up she'll have a loving family by her side. And I'll cover the whole palace with a thorny hedge to and I'll make sure they know. In 100 years, something lies beneath the lights.
After 100 years, a prince came to the castle. He had heard a story of a cursed princess and had come to see if he could help. The thorns parted in his path, allowing him to pass.
The stories are true, the stories are true. There's a castle behind these walls. That one's where the princess needs help.
The prince went into the courtyard, through the hall, and up to the tower. All of the inhabitants of the castle were asleep. At the top of the tallest tower, he found the sleeping princess.
I wonder what will wake her.
Oh, you saved me. Thank you.
The pleasure was all mine. You're beautiful.
With the princess awake, the good fairy's spell of sleep lifted from the rest of the castle.
Princess, you're back!
Thank you, good prince. I'm so sorry I sent her away. The pleasure is all mine. I've met my true love.
The prince and the princess are married and they lived happily ever after.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.